Good morning, everyone.
Morning.
We are from group number 5. My name is Anita. My friends are Nadia. Hello. And Katiari. Today, we are going to show you our presentation about dimension of symptoms. And now conversation.
Oh, my stomach is too bad. What is it like? It seems a needle prick on my stomach.
Please lie down here. I will give a first aid.
Thanks.
This might help you the health the pain. Don't move, just lie down several minutes.
Thanks a lot.
What do you feel now?
I feel better now.
I'm happy to hear that. Does the pain occur frequently?
I feel better now. No, it does not. I just suffer it.
When did you will feel it?
This morning, it hurt again.
You are not totally correct. That please still allow the lie down here. The doctor will examine you.
Can you give them medicine?
Sorry, I cannot. But you can use it to help the pain.
Nice.
And next reading, dengue fever symptoms. Dengue fever is endemic in tropical and subtropical areas. Dengue fever is estimated by the World Health Organization to cause about 50 until 100 million infections per year worldwide. The U.S. Center for Disease Control and Prevention considers dengue fever to cause the majority of acute febrile illnesses in travelers returning to the U.S. The first clinical report of dengue fever was in 1789 by B. Russ. Although the Chinese may have described the disease associated with flying insect as early as 420 AD, Africans described Kadinga Pepo as cramp-like seizure caused by an evil spirit. The Spanish may have changed Dinga to dengue since it means fastidious or careful in Spanish, which describes the gait of people trying to reduce the pain of walking. Unfortunately, the disease incidence seems to be increasing. Researchers suggest to surge in dengue fever may be due to several factors. It is urban crowding with more sites for mosquitoes to default, and international commerce that contains infected mosquitoes, thus introducing the disease to areas previously free of the disease. And local and world environmental change that allow mosquitoes to survive the winter months. Next, international travelers who carry the disease to area where mosquitoes have not been previously infected.
Has spread widely throughout the world. We have all distribution map
show that dengue fever mainly occurs in tropical and subtropical area. In the U.S., dengue fever has been detected in California, Florida, Texas, and Hawaii. Other area where it has been detected or there has been an outbreak of the disease include the Philippines, Taiwan, Samoa, Brazil, Puerto Rico, Costa Rica, Thailand, and New Delhi. However, as climate warm, experts suggest dengue will become more prevalent. In 2015, an outbreak of dengue fever occurred in New Delhi, the worst in 5 years. Over 10,000 people test positive for dengue fever. There have been at least 32 death attributes to this outbreak. States run hospital were so overcrowded that patients were sharing bed. An independent group, Brandeis University, suggests the actual number of people in India with dengue are vastly under report. Next, Kak.
Nadika.
Secara demam berdarah. Demam berdarah dengue merupakan penyakit endemik di daerah tropis dan subtropis. Demam berdarah diperkirakan dari Organisasi Kesehatan Dunia atau WHO menyebabkan sekitar 50-100 juta infeksi per tahun di seluruh dunia. Pusat Pengendalian dan Pencegahan Penyakit Amerika Serikat menganggap demam berdarah sebagai penyebab sebagian besar penyakit demam akut pada wisatawan yang kembali ke Amerika Serikat. Laporan klinis pertama demam berdarah adalah pada tahun 1789 oleh Biras. Meskipun orang Cina mungkin telah mengembangkan penyakit yang terkait dengan serangga terbang sedini mungkin, 420 AD, orang Afrika menggambarkan Kadinga Pepo sebagai kejang seperti kram yang disebabkan oleh roh jahat. Bahasa Spanyol mungkin telah mengubah dinga menjadi demam berdarah karena artinya sangat kritis atau hati-hati dalam bahasa Spanyol, yang menggambarkan orang yang mencoba mengurangi rasa sakit saat berjalan. Sayangnya, insiden penyakit tampaknya meningkat. Peneliti menyarankan lonjakan demam berdarah mungkin karena beberapa faktor. Yang pertama, meningkatnya kepadatan perkotaan dengan lebih banyak tempat berkembang biaknya nyamuk. Yang kedua, perdagangan internasional yang mengandung nyamuk yang terinfeksi, sehingga memperkenalkan penyakit daerah-daerah yang sebelumnya bebas dari penyakit. Yang ketiga, perubahan lingkungan lokal dan dunia yang memungkinkan nyamuk bertahan hidup di musim dingin. Yang keempat, wisatawan internasional yang membawa penyakit ke daerah di mana nyamuk belum pernah terinfeksi sebelumnya. Demam berdarah telah menyebar luas di seluruh dunia. Peta sebaran WHO menunjukkan bahwa penyakit demam berdarah terutama terjadi di daerah tropis dan subtropis. Di Amerika Serikat, demam berdarah telah terdeteksi di California, Florida, Texas, dan Hawaii. Daerah lain di mana telah terdeteksi oleh atau telah terjadi wabah penyakit termasuk Filipina, Taiwan, Samoa, Brazil, Puerto Rico, Costa Rica, Thailand, dan New Delhi. Namun saat iklim menghangat, para ahli memprediksi demam berdarah akan menjadi lebih umum. Pada 2015, wabah demam berdarah terjadi di New Delhi yang terburuk dalam 5 tahun, lebih dari 10.000 orang dinyatakan positif dengan demam berdarah. Setidaknya ada 32 kematian yang dikaitkan dengan wabah ini. Rumah sakit yang dikelola negara begitu penuh sesak sehingga masyarakat berbagi tempat tidur. Sebuah kelompok independen di Universitas Brandeis menunjukkan jumlah sebenarnya orang di India dengan demam berdarah sangat tidak dilaporkan.
Next sekali, Kak.
simple present tense. The simple present tense is a verb tense with the main use. We use the simple present tense when action is happening right now or when it happens regularly. Next. From a simple tense, present tense verbal. Positive subject plus verb plus complete. Example, she goes to school. Subjeknya I, you, they, we. Plus verb satu, plus object, adjective, or a plot. He, she, it. Plus verb, plus s, plus object, adjective, adverbs. Example, she goes to school. Negative, subject plus auxiliary plus not plus verb plus complete. Subjectnya I, you, they, we plus do not plus verb one plus object adjective adverb. We see it plus does not verb plus s plus object adjective adverb. Example, she does not go to school. Question, auxiliary, plus not, plus s, subject, plus verb, plus complete. Do, plus I, you, they, we, plus verb one, plus object, adjective, a verb. Does, plus he, she, it, plus verb, plus s, plus objective, adjective, adverb. Example, does she go to school?
Positive, subject plus to be plus complements. I plus to be plus object plus adjective, adverb. He, she, atau it plus to be atau is plus object plus adjective plus adverb. You, we, they, plus to be, atau are, plus object, objective, adverb. Example, he is very patient. Negative, subject, plus to be, plus not, plus complements. I, plus to be, at or not, am, not, plus object, objective, plus adverb. He, she, it, plus to be, is not a person plus object plus adjective plus adverb. You, we, they plus to be, are not, are or are not, aren't plus object plus adjective plus adverb, adjective, adverb. Example, he is not Eastern very patient. Question, to be plus subject plus complements. To be or I'm plus I plus object plus adjective adverb. To be is plus he, she, it plus object plus adjective adverb. To be are plus you, we, they plus object adjective adverb. Is he patient? Is he patient?
Times like now, at birth of time, every year setiap tahun, every month setiap bulan, at 7 jam 7, here or there, di sini atau di sana, every week setiap minggu, in the morning di pagi hari, every day setiap hari, twice a day dua kali sehari. Adverb of frequency, seldom, sering, always, selalu. Sometimes, kadang-kadang, as a rule, lazimnya, often, setiap, ever, pernah, nowadays, pada waktu sekarang, frequently, di sini atau di sana, one in a while, kadang-kadang, normally, umumnya, commonly, biasanya, generally, seringkali.